Don't worry, Lester. It'll be okay. I hope.
I'm so sorry, sir. Let me clean that up. Welcome to Budapest.
It's rumored that all the victims turned into vampires. That's why Dr. F is keeping them in the hospital.
Darling, did you hear? Another man was attacked. They say it's a vampire.
Are you a tourist? You'll need an amulet to protect you from vampires. But unfortunately, I don't have any left. I'd like to give you a souvenir to remember Budapest. Here, I hope you can use them.
It's glowing. Does that mean there's a vampire nearby?
Look! A bat!
It's a vampire! Help! Trapped! Sir, please help me. I'm stuck here. You'll need a ladder to raise the chandelier. There's one near the brewery. Please hurry. I'm blocked in. Please lift the chandelier. You'll need a ladder to raise the chandelier. You'll need a ladder to raise the chandelier. There are tools in the bag, but I can't reach you. Maybe you can hook it with something. There are tools in the bag, but I can't reach you. Maybe you can hook it with something. Thank you. You should have everything you need now, sir. Thank you. My name is Agatha, and I sent you that letter. I admire your work, so I was a bit embarrassed to approach you right away, especially after that spill. I'm investigating vampire attacks myself, but I hit a dead end. I'm sure you could solve it, though. Here are my notes so far.
Agatha asked me to investigate the vampire attacks in Budapest. Her brother Mark was one of the victims. The locals wear amulets to protect them from vampires, so why did an ordinary bat make them glow? Something doesn't add up. This case could get interesting.
Thank you for helping, Detective. The constable won't want to talk to me after our last meeting. He doesn't believe a woman can be a detective, but I'll do whatever I can to help. We can use my brother's car. I'm looking after it while he's in the hospital. It'll get us to the city faster. Use the key to start the ignition, Detective. It looks like one of the lights burned out. I saw a spare somewhere around here. Now you need to change the lights, Detective. It shouldn't be complicated. Great. I think we're ready to go. You've been very helpful. Here, take this.
Look out!
You're both lucky. These newfangled cars are dangerous. You could have hurt someone or disturbed the crime scene. There was another attack here tonight.
I'm very sorry. I'm glad you're okay, Detective. But Lester's gone. I need to make sure he's okay, too. I'll take a quick look around and then help your investigation.
I need to get the vampire's victim to a hospital right away. You broke the wheel, so you must help me fix the carriage. The constable will be here soon. You can pester him with questions. Here are the tools. The patient could be dangerous. You must stay away. Thank you for your help. Dr. F. believes that the victims can become vampires themselves, so they're kept in strict isolation for the good of the city. Will you be alone in this wilderness? Aren't you afraid of vampires? You're brave, but I just can't leave you. Here, take this for self-defense.
Constable Laszlo, at your service. What can I do for you? Hang on, are you a private detective? I've had enough of Agatha prying into police business. Stay out of my way, or I'll arrest you for obstruction. Go back to where you came from. I'm warning you, detective, stay out of my investigation.
The evidence suggests that the attack took place elsewhere and the body was dumped here. I wonder if the constable will put that in the report.
I didn't find Lester. so at least he wasn't injured in the accident. He knows the area well, so I'm sure he'll find his way home. Laszlo is rude and arrogant, but it gets worse. I've heard that he belongs to some secret order. I don't know what role this organization plays in what's happening to this city, but I'm sure Laszlo is hiding something. Let's take this opportunity to search his office while he and his people are busy. Mark's car is damaged, but the boat will buy us some time.
I'm warning you, Detective, stay out of my investigation.
Get out of here, vampire!
Detective, someone is hiding in the captain's cabin.
Who's there? Are you a detective? I'm Captain Constantine, and this ship is going nowhere. There's a vampire on board. Aren't you afraid? Well, I know how to protect myself from vampires. Bring me the items on my list, and then I'll take you to the other side.
Well, he's definitely cracked, but we don't have much choice. I'll check the lower deck. I haven't found anything yet.
Those bloodsuckers won't get me now! I'll take you across the river, but keep in mind that the city is not quiet. Today's the lunar eclipse from the prophecy! They say Dracula himself has awakened. Did you know that he lived here? Yes, these shores hold many secrets. Ask your girlfriend. If she's a local, she should know all the urban legends. And wipe your hands. They're all dirty.
Come here, Detective. These places are shrouded in legends about vampires. I'll be your guide. See that castle on the hill? If you use your imagination, you can see traces of history in the landscape. We're arriving soon, Detective.
Hold on, Agatha! We're going to turn over!
You saved my life, Detective. Thank you. At least we made it across the river. The constable's office is down the street. But first, we need to get warm.
Aren't you afraid of the eclipse? Or are you hoping to get bitten too? Please note that we're the first in line for immortality. I'm Casimir, and this is Erica.
They're drenched, Casimir. Oh, but the fire has gone out. We need more firewood. Take this mirror and let the girl clean herself up. Now you can dry off quickly. Yes, Casimir and I want to get bitten. Why does that surprise you? Vampires are immortal. They can fly, and they live in castles.
Anything is better than living on these dangerous streets. Take this as a thank you for starting the fire. I won't need it when I become a vampire. It's broken, but it'll keep people from messing with you.
Is coming true!
Now's our chance to get into the constable's office.
Where do you think you're going? The constable is out hunting vampires. I can't let you through.
Thanks to your mysterious supplier, these Order of the Dragon amulets are keeping citizens safe from the vampires.
I'm happy to help in any way I can, Constable.
While making a fortune out of it, right, Bianca?
I don't...
If you keep raising your prices, I'll be forced to act. You don't want to go to jail for fraud, do you?
Detective? Are you with the Order of the Dragon, too? I've told Constable Lazio everything. Oh! It's a vampire! He's come for me! No! Go away!
No! Go away! Thank you. My nerves are shot. I'll tell you everything I know. A strange man offered to sell me these amulets. He promised to bring me a new batch tonight. I'm to meet him at the docks, but I'd rather get out of this business. The constable has bothered me ever since I started selling them. Maybe I'll do seances instead. What do you think? You can meet the supplier yourself. There is a shortcut to the docks from the square through the gate. Here's the key.
Bianca's mysterious supplier met her at the docks, the same place where the attacks occur, according to the constable's reports. I know the typical victim profile and hunting ground. Erica and Casimir's crazy idea might help me solve this case. To catch the vampire, I'll become its victim.
You're right. Baiting the criminal at the docks is our best chance. But I should be the bait, not you. Don't argue. We have a better chance of your springing the ambush. All I need is men's clothing for the vampire to choose me. Well, do I look like a gentleman? Let's go, Detective. We still have to find a good location for an ambush. Don't worry, Detective. I know what I'm doing. I wanted to tell you something, but I think it can wait until we solve this case. Here, keep this with you until I get back.
She was attacked by a vampire? Thank you for bringing her to us. I can take things from here. Dr. F doesn't have time for any visitors. You need a good reason to come inside. No, no. Who's that nurse, Valent? Wait, are these the bat bites? Those could be dangerous. Follow me. I'll take care of you, detective.
Awake already. I warned you to stay out of this. You're under arrest on suspicion of assault. You were detained while trying to enter the hospital. You had the fangs of a vampire with you. You won't be going anywhere for a long time, detective.
What? Who's here? No, I suppose it doesn't really matter. My name's Gaspard, and I'm an astronomer. Laszlo put me here. How did you wind up here? Are you a detective? They put everyone in jail, regardless of who they are. I was locked up for telling people the scientific facts about the eclipse. I'm against all this superstitious nonsense about vampires. Here, have a look. Unbelievable! You found a way out! We can take shelter in my observatory. Educated people should stick together. Besides, I have something to help you with your investigation. You won't believe what I saw through the telescope. Hurry! I know the way over the rooftops.
There's obviously a human behind the attacks. They
unhinged tricks to make it look like a vampire was to blame. Someone is using Constable Laszlo and the Order of the Dragon for their own purposes. They obviously support this vampire charade.
Welcome to my observatory, Detective. This is where I conduct my research. And there's my beloved telescope, my treasure. Go ahead, take a look. The key for it must be around here somewhere. Please help me find it. happened to my observatory? Look, everything was destroyed. Detective, please, help me figure out what happened here.
This is clearly the work of a criminal. He smashed the equipment at Gaspard's observatory. After that, he climbed the boxes to escape through the window.
What? Someone broke into my observatory? Unbelievable. I'll check the archive to see if my old work is still intact. I can only show you the evidence I mentioned if you fix the telescope. I have instructions that you can use. The archive was damaged as well. What a nightmare. So many years of work, all for nothing. Oh, my telescope. You fixed it. Did you see the strange cluster of bats in the cemetery? It seems something is attracting them. This will help you go there. Here, take this, and thank you.
The criminal tries to intimidate those who get in his way. He doesn't want anyone to doubt the rumors about the connection between vampires and the Eclipse. Perhaps he's also behind the gathering of bats. It's worth investigating. Someone passed by here and disappeared through the gate in that gazebo. If I want to find them, I must get there.
Why are you following me? Did you mistake me for a vampire? Hardly!
I'm Irene, a zoologist. I study bats and how to control their behavior. I'll prove it to you. Here, put these herbs in the bait in the crypt. You'll see for yourself.
Thank you.
See the ring on her paw? She came all the way from the south. Bats are my passion, and it looks like there's someone else's as well. I recently saw someone resembling a vampire in the castle window. I didn't dare to get closer. But if you're looking for vampires, you should take a look.
Don't hit me, I'm just an actor. My name is David. I always wanted to portray Dracula, and I got too used to playing the role. After all, the pallor suits me. I had an illness that made my skin like this. Dr. F treated me. I have a certificate in the closet to prove it.
I think I see who's at the center of all this. The one who used Irene, David, and Bianca to create vampire hysteria in the city. The same man who fooled the naive Lazlo. Dr. F is behind all this. But why?
Do you need to see Dr. F? Then you should go to the hospital. Here, take the key to my carriage. But promise you'll return it to me in one piece. Unfortunately, I can't go with you. While I may be good at playing a vampire, I'm actually very afraid of blood and hospitals. Good luck, Detective!
I've been waiting for you, Detective. Congratulations, Detective. You figured out my plan. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Victoria Frankenstein. It seems that I've finally met someone who matches my intelligence. But it doesn't matter. My son Adam will be saved. You win, Detective. I give up. Please, grant the last request of a desperate mother. Let me start the machine and save my son. Don't let the sacrifices be for nothing. I'm sure the formula will work.